Israel isn't backing down on its promise to respond to Iran's strike despite cries for de-escalation from world leaders.
If we don't answer, the Iranians will feel impunity, and they will feel that they can strike anywhere in the Middle East or elsewhere without any consequences.
Iran continues to warn Israel over the anticipated response. A senior commander told an Iranian news agency the country could look to review its nuclear doctrine over Israeli threats. FBI Director Christopher Wray says the Bureau is on alert for threats to the Jewish community in America as the Passover holiday approaches. The Anti-Defamation League says anti-Semitic incidents ballooned in 2023, with almost 9,000 incidents of assault and harassment, a 140% increase since 2022.
We at the Bureau remain particularly concerned that lone actors could target large gatherings, high-profile events, or symbolic or religious locations for violence. Particularly a concern, of course, as we look to the start of Passover on Monday evening.
Congress has tried to pass multiple bills this week condemning Iran and supporting Israel.
My resolution condemns the slogan, "From the river to the sea, Palestine will be free," because it is blatantly anti-Semitic.
That resolution passed with strong bipartisan support, but was opposed by 43 Democrats and one Republican. The liberal so-called squad members were among those voting against the measure, including Congresswoman Rashida Tlaib, who said she wouldn't support any of the messaging bills until there's a ceasefire in Gaza.
This is why we must achieve an immediate permanent ceasefire that includes an end to the genocide in Gaza.
The U.S. hit Iran with new sanctions on Thursday, targeting its drone program and some steel companies. It's an effort to cut Iran off from the weapons they used to try and strike Israel. In Washington, I'm Matt Galka.